Annyeong, 친구! Starting next week, I'll be in Seoul and be creating travel vlogs. For this week, I thought it might be helpful for you guys to see what I'm packing for Korea and beyond. For those watching my other channel, Miss Mina Oh, you know that I'm going to Asia for a couple months. Korea is the first stop. This is my main bag. I won't be checking in any baggage. And I have a second bag for laptop and other electronics. And you guys, I'm gonna be upfront. I have two items that are sponsored in this video. It is this bag right here, and another one is this portable toothbrush by Quip. It comes with a cap that sticks on surfaces such as mirrors, which makes it travel friendly. And although it doesn't vibrate as strong as the electric brush I have at home, Quip's brush is battery powered and is quite light. The discount code for refill brushes is in the description box, along with other sponsored links. Everything I'm packing falls under four main categories: clothes, toiletry, electronics, and other. Let's find out what I put in here already so far. A lot of you guys know that my style is pretty minimal. I'm gonna be bringing more shirts like this. This one is made of linen. Because it's still August in Korea, still a bit warm, so this will come in handy. Here's another top. I need to laundry this, but that's another top I'm gonna bring. I always roll my clothing up. It saves a lot of space. It's like golden rule number one of travel packing. Roll it up tightly. And of course the other top is gonna be the one I wear to Korea. I typically wear white tank tops underneath all these shirts. The thing is though, if you love eating food, whether it's street food or noodles or, you know, you like to get all slurped up, all those lovely colorful juices might get on your clothes. So in that case, especially if you're a messy eater, I recommend bringing dark colored clothing so then you don't have to do your laundry as much. So I'm gonna be bringing a couple tanks to go with these shirts. He's a casual, thicker tank. And of course I gotta bring my undies. I'm bringing seven, one for each day of the week. Then on the seventh day, I do my laundry. Whenever I pack underwear for traveling, I always consider that I might gain and lose weight. Because if you go and travel, like, you won't eat all these kinds of foods, so you might gain a couple pounds. So I always try to bring flexible and forgiving underwear that doesn't make like multiple bumps on your butt. I'm also bringing three pairs of pants. Blue jeans, green jeans, and then purple jeans. How about pajamas? It's gonna be pretty warm wherever I go, so I'm gonna be bringing shorts. Here's another short. And from pajama tops, I'm gonna be wearing this shirt. This is from Kore, K-O-R-E. This means YOLO in Korean. And this is just another random second shirt for my pajama. What probably will happen is I'll be wearing my second pajama outfit while I do laundry. There's certain things I'm not gonna pack because when I go to Korea, I will get them. This includes a party shoe like high heels as well as a dress. I rarely go swimming whenever I visit Korea. However, I'm gonna bring a set of swimsuits just in case and a pair of prescribed goggles. I'm also bringing this guy. It's very thin, but it's also very warm. So if any case like I get a little cold, which I highly doubt, I will wear this. I typically bring this to Korea when it's winter time. I'm bringing this more for December because I'll be in an Asian country where it will get a little chilly. I'm also bringing these casual flip-flops that I've been wearing for the past year. Thing is, I don't want to bring anything like super expensive or super new. I'm gonna be wearing my normal thing, and when something wears out or I get a hole or something goes missing, stolen, I don't know, like whatever happens, I'm ready. It's okay to shop as you go along on the trip. I'll also be packing seven pairs of socks. There's a zipper here, and then there's another pocket, and then yet another zipper. On the other side of the inside of the bag, we have places where you could put like pens or like stick things in there. And then you have side pockets which you could put other stuff in. And in this side pocket, I have a book. A lot of you guys may know that when you're bringing carry-on, you have a limit to how much liquids you could bring. The rules may change over time, but on the TSA website, it says travel size containers are limited to 3.4 ounces or less per item. So each container cannot go over 3.4 ounces. And all these small size containers with liquids in it, they must fit in a 1 quart size resealable bag. This is a 1 quart size resealable bag. Question is, should you do checked in baggage or should you do carry on like me? It depends on the purpose of your trip. If you're going for shopping, then definitely bring a suitcase and you check it in. Then make sure you leave a lot of empty space in your bag. My trip is not about shopping, it's about enjoying the sights and eating. So I won't be packing the pounds into a bag, I'll be packing pounds onto this. Well, hopefully this area, but typically it goes somewhere else. So here we have our carry-on approved bag for liquids. Now I'm not huge on makeup, but I do need my lotion, my toner, and my other makeup goodies. But one of the problems with packing liquids is you never know if the bottle's gonna explode and leak all over the place. I bought this on Amazon and supposedly it's really good for traveling. So these are my TSA approved containers that I'll be putting my liquids in. This one will have my toner, this one my facial lotion. Right now they're empty because when I go to Korea, I will fill them with the products I buy at Face Shop and other Korean skincare companies. This outside is silicone based, so it might not do well with certain liquids. So it's good to test the product by putting your lotion and like other things that you usually use before you take it for traveling. Sunscreen for the face. Primer! I also have a 2 week Quip toothpaste, mosquito insect repellent, concealer by Stila, nail polish remover. As for the actual nail polish, I might just buy one bottle in Korea. And this one contains a BB cream. Well, actually I gotta fill it up all the way to the top. So this is a BB cream that I use currently. I'm gonna use a small spoon and put it in the other container. Let's zip it! I might have to rearrange a couple of these items. Hopefully it zips this time. And it does. Alright, that's my liquids bag. This is my non-liquids toiletry bag. You open it, and then here we have a pouch for longer like pencil makeups or like a toothbrush. And here I have a tongue scraper. This tongue scraper used to be long, but I chopped it down in 1/3 of its length so I could fit it in here. My powder makeup, brush. I also have my pimple patches, acne patches. Whenever I get a whitehead or even like a little small red bump, I put it on there at nighttime and then when I wake up, it's gone. Second pair of glasses, just in case. Hair ties, hair band. And I have 2 extra sets of makeup powder. These brushes are getting quite old, so when I get to Korea, I'm gonna buy new ones to replace them and toss these out. As a female, we have something else to consider. That little friend that likes to visit us every month. Now, I've been to a couple countries. I don't like using their pads, tampons, panty liners, so I like to bring my own. I have my own set here, filled with all kinds of female products. I know the dudes might be cringing, like, oh wow, why are you showing this female stuff, but come on. If you love eating food abroad, I definitely recommend bringing some Pepto-Bismol, anti-diarrhea pills. I've never gotten sick eating street food or food in general in Korea. Also, I'm gonna bring a bottle of probiotic pills. And you might be wondering, things like shampoo, conditioner, body lotion, what else, like sunscreen, stuff like that I'm gonna be getting at the country wherever I go. And a lot of the accommodations I go to, they're gonna be providing those goods. Oh, one other thing I'm bringing is this quick dry towel. It's very absorbent. Whew. Thankfully it zips. As for electronics, I'm gonna be bringing my laptop. I'm also gonna be bringing my vlogging camera, which I am recording with right now, so you can't see yourself, can you, camera? Also bringing 2 external hard drives. Always make sure you have backup. And on top of that, I'm gonna be using an online service to upload my footage on there as a third backup. Also bring my GorillaPod. Also gonna bring my vlogging camera charger and an extra battery. I am 90% sure this will be my backup camera. It doesn't do too well with audio, but it's better than nothing. And of course, last but not least, the passport. I'm bringing my yellow card as well that shows all the shots I got. I bought traveler's insurance and I printed out copies of it. So if my internet goes down, I don't have access to it with like mobile data, then at least I have it in paper so I know exactly like what to do. I have the important numbers on there. All this will go in my backpack. And that is pretty much everything I'll be packing for my trip. I'll see you guys next week in Korea. 안녕!
If you visit during the winter, you'll definitely want to bring a thick jacket or coat. It does snow. Without an onward ticket, you may be denied to board your flight. The standard voltage in South Korea is 220 volts. Make sure all your essential info is on a paper. Whether you wrote it down or printed all that info, just have a physical copy.
Take a look at that! Oh, I really love the texture on this. It's very like bumpy because of the corns. And... If you don't see your friend for a very long time,